What's going on, guys? It is Call of Duty. I know, Call of Duty. This isn't sports. I enjoy playing other types of games. Call of Duty was my favorite game of all time. When I first got my Xbox, I started playing. Actually, I bought my Xbox because of Gears of War, that commercial. I just couldn't believe that was a video game, how amazing the graphics and gameplay looked. So I bought a Xbox 360 because of it. I was always a gaming guy, or a PC gamer, I should say. Played a lot of Quake, a lot of Unreal Tournament, things like that. So I was used to the keyboard and mouse. But after seeing that Gears of War commercial, I had to get an Xbox just because it looked so flippin' amazing. And then, likewise, when I got the Xbox, I ended up getting Call of Duty 4, which was out at the time. I played Call of Duty 3, I believe, never played it online. It just wasn't very fun to me. But then I got Call of Duty 4 and started playing online, and it changed my life in video games, just because it was something so amazing about Call of Duty 4, just the way, how easy it was to get into games and play, and it really taught me how to use the controller correctly. Obviously, coming from a keyboard and mouse, it was a lot different switching to a normal Xbox controller to play. Call of Duty really is what got me into YouTube, obviously. If you ask most people, maybe today is a little different, but most people on YouTube that play video games started with Call of Duty in some way or another. It's just that big of a game, that big of a series, that big of a community. So I wanted to talk a little bit about community today. With Robert Bowling leaving Activision a few weeks ago or whatever, there's been a lot of talk about community and what the community means and how the community has changed over the years. I think community, that word is thrown around a lot, and it's kind of unfair. Obviously, there's communities for pretty much every game, and community on the whole, just because you play the game, I guess you're technically part of the community, but there's so many different aspects of the community that it's unfair to just label everybody part of that problem. Because typically when you hear the word community, it's usually a negative thing that's going to come right after it. So I think that's kind of unfair, especially with Call of Duty, because there's so many different sub-communities in that giant Call of Duty community that it's unfair that they get labeled negative when there's a lot of positive stuff that comes out of it. For example, there's a pretty big community that does MLG stuff, so competitive gaming, where they play the game completely different than most of us play. They are all about playing with the same people all the time, learning all they can learn about the guns, the maps, the spawn points, where things happen, the choke points, teamwork, communication. It's completely different than just joining a game and trying to get as many kills as you can or whatever. It's a lot different, and they're a lot different type of player. They're a lot different type of people. You also have people that do clan stuff, so that's where my big thing was. Once I got into Modern Warfare 2, I started getting into clans, and I had some friends that would play here and there, but it wasn't a normal thing. Like, we wouldn't play like normal times, so I wanted to get into a clan where I could, whenever I logged in, there would be people from the clan on, so I could get into a game lobby with people that I know. I was just tired of getting put on teams that would just get destroyed, so I started playing with clans, and it really improved my game a lot. And then another part of the community is the YouTube community. Now, this is the one that gets probably the most heat, and when you talk community, that's probably more than likely you're talking about the YouTube Call of Duty community, which is fair because they have the biggest voice, obviously. They're posting videos on YouTube for people to watch. They're able to give their opinions on it, and that's what people take. I just remember, well, let me say this first. The negative always outshines the positive. So, for example, that voice that people talk about, or the voice that displays negative energy and talks about all the bad things and talks about all the complaining and all that stuff, is almost always the voice that you hear over the voice that enjoy the game, enjoy playing the game, that sort of stuff. So I can understand why people would say that the community is negative. Like I said, if you're enjoying the game and you're having fun playing it and whatever, you're not going to be spending your time posting bulletins or posting videos about shitty stuff that happens. You're going to be posting stuff that, you know, montages or whatever. It's all those negative ones that get the most views. It's the negative ones that people flood to. And it's the negative ones that get picked up by everybody that's, oh, this is the game. This is why it sucks. Which is unfortunate. Obviously, with Modern Warfare 3, that's gotten worse. And maybe it is because the game is not up to par with the other games. I've never really had that much of an issue with Modern Warfare 3. My biggest complaint was that I just was getting stale, like it was the same things over and over again. Obviously, you can argue that with every single game in the world. MLB The Show is the same way. It's pretty much the same game every year, isn't it? I mean, it's still baseball. How much can they change in it? It's the same with Call of Duty. I mean, obviously they need some sort of overhaul. But at the same time, the game sells, like, amazingly. It also, everybody still, well, not everybody, but it still gets millions of people playing it every day. So how much incentive do they really have to change a lot? And like I said, that people that are complaining is probably only 10% of the actual community. But sorry for the rant. I just wanted to talk a little bit to you guys about that kind of stuff. It's been a while since I did Call of Duty stuff, and I plan on playing it more and more. So all right, guys, I'll talk to you later. Peace.